The show is about what would happen if all the lights went off and never came back on.
Every single piece of electricity, circuitry, technology has shut down forever. And we really see what the world would be like, which is basically, for all intents and purposes, a second Dark Ages.
So this show takes place 15 years after the blackout. And when you meet this community, they're in this sort of protected cul-de-sac. People are farming in their own, you know, backyards, and there are militaries that have sort of popped up.
I'm gonna have to ask you to come with us under the authority of the Monroe Republic.
Ben knows much more about why the lights went out than he's letting on, and he's keeping incredible secrets from Charlie and from Maggie, and he's forced to reveal the secret to Aaron.
Keep it safe, do you understand?
Ben, nothing is gonna happen.
Aaron, please.
We actually joke about this. Ben actually knew every secret there is to know in the show, but we blew him away, so.
I play Charlie. She starts out as a girl who's just looking for adventure and wants to go out and see the world.
She's sort of penned up by this particular village and, more importantly, by her father.
There is nothing worth seeing, not anymore.
For Ben, the world is a really dangerous place. For Charlie, the world is a really promising and exciting place.
There's other towns like ours, right?
Charlie is born with a sense of adventure, and she doesn't really understand the dangers that come along with the adventure and the things that are outside of her area. She's eager to see it all, but has no idea what's coming her way.
Enough.
I play Captain Tom Neville, who is the head of the militia.
Neville isn't a typical bad guy.
He's very intelligent and very refined, looking down his nose at these people who are living like pigs.
My God. What a beautiful village.
He gets things that he needs to get from people, not by threatening them all the time, but by being polite.
What did you do before the blackout?
Sorry?
Just curious.
Because he keeps you off base. He's a brilliant investigator, an interrogator. He's formidable as an adversary.
Yeah, I was an insurance adjuster. Most of my job was figuring out whether the things people said lined up with the truth.
And he makes these switches from in between those very, very quickly, so people don't know what to expect.
Wait, your Uncle Miles?
Underwhelmed?
Charlie and Miles actually really need each other.
So what do we do now?
What do we do now about what?
Charlie needs Miles for all the obvious reasons. He knows how this world works. He's totally badass with a sword. But for, you know, slightly less obvious and much more emotional reasons, Miles needs Charlie.
He sees the little girl that he once knew and realizes, oh, this is for real.
He has every reason to say no and very little reason to say yes. But he says yes, and that's sort of an interesting thing. Which we'll explore as we go on more and more in the series.
Like all these types of characters, there's always somewhere in there, there's a soft center. So she squeezes that a little bit, and off they go down the road.
As someone who writes and produces and you know, works with stories, the cell phone and instant communication actually gets in the way of a lot of drama. It makes it harder to tell stories of incredible drama because everyone can know everything instantly. And what this show does, it basically eliminates that possibility. And so this world that we're gonna be seeing through the eyes of these characters that aren't quite sure what they're gonna find either is this incredible epic journey that that Eric Kripke, I think, brilliantly has come up with.
If anything, this is a family drama.
You know, I didn't ask you to come back.
Don't look at me. I wanted to let you rot.
Why didn't you?
Because we're family.
Family is what you make of it, and it doesn't have to be connected by blood. And it can be your friends, or it can be this sort of disparate group of travelers who sort of find themselves together on the road. And if there's any one overall lesson of the show, is that none of us can do it alone.